In this video, I'm gonna talk about Firebase App Check. So if you don't know what is Firebase App Check, you can watch the video. Stay with me. Hi there, this is Imaneo. Welcome to my channel. So in this channel, we talk about software engineering, we talk about game development, we talk about security and a lot more. So you can subscribe the channel and turn on the notification to get notified when we have a new video or a new content. So basically in this video, I'm gonna talk about Firebase App Check. Basically, it's an added security layer on top of your application. And the point is that it makes sure that the requests are coming from the application that you created to the server. So you have your application, you have your client here, you have your server here, and it makes sure that all the requests are generated from the application, not from a hacker or anyone else. So if you take a look at this image, you can see that App Check is something that protects your backend or your service. And it makes sure that the request is coming from the actual user or the client that you have. So basically it's a header. So it's nothing more than a header. It just adds a header on the request. It might be a HTTP request. It might be a gRPC request. It might be a socket and you have some stream. So it works on any kind of request that you might have. And it just adds a header on the request or a token on the request. And in your backend, you can check the token and you can validate that it is coming from the application. The point is that it uses some techniques to make sure that the token is only can be generated in the application that is signed by you. So for example, you can sign the application with your Key Store in Android, and then with some techniques, it can make sure that the token is generated from the application. And I'm not gonna talk about the details because they are written down here. You can learn about them, but I just want to give the idea to you. So yeah, basically it creates the token and the token is time-based. So you can choose a time, an interval that it invalidates the token and a new token should be generated. So for example, you can say, every 30 minutes. So a token is only valid for 30 minutes. And after that, the client needs to generate a new token. And if I open the other image, yeah, you see that it works like this. There is an App Check SDK on your client, on your mobile app, on your web app. And at first you request to get a new token. So App Check token, and then you can put it on your request. So if you have HTTPS request, you can add it on the headers. If you have gRPC, you can add it on the request. And if you have some sockets or streams, you can just put the token inside the data that is going to the server. And in the backend, you can add the App Check Verify SDK. So you can find it. It has the SDK for Python. It has the SDK for TypeScript and other languages and frameworks. So you can just get the token from client and ask the App Check Verify to verify that the request or the token is coming from the application that you signed or you created. And the point is that you can add the App Check layer security to the application that you developed with any framework or any method of communication. It's just a token, and in the backend, you can just validate the token. And yeah, so the point is that it works everywhere. At first, I was thinking that it is only for Firebase functions and Firebase storage, but later I realized that you can just implement it in your customized backend or customized framework or anything that you are using. So basically it's a token and the backend validates the token. And yeah, so I just wanted to give you the overview or the idea of how App Check works. And if you want to know more details about it, you can check the link that I will put it into the description. So here there are a lot of documentations that you can read about, but I just wanted to give you the overview. And yeah, so thanks for watching this video. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button because it motivates me to publish or create more videos here on this channel. And stay tuned for the next video. Bye.